Hi students, good morning. Today we are going to discuss the third chapter of civics, that is Salient Features of Indian Constitution part 2. And in this chapter we will discuss about two important points. Only these points are these points will come from the syllabus. These are the only important points from this chapter. First one is meaning of the directive principles. What is directive principles of state policy? First of all, we need to see the definition of directive principles of state policy. Please, I will read that. The directive principles are the guidelines to be followed by the government in the governance of the country. What are directive principles? These are guidelines given to the government to be followed. Okay, these are the guidelines how to govern a country. So directive principles of state policy are the guidelines to be followed by a government to when they govern a country. So which part of the constitution deals with directive principles of state policy? Part 4 of the constitution. Part 4, articles 36 to 51 deals with the directive principles of state policy. Then the directive principles are not a substitute for laws of the country. They are not the substitute. Directive principles cannot be set as the rules or laws. They are only a guidelines. Okay, it is not compulsory that they have to follow, but it is advised to follow. They are called directive principles because the government has to take them into consideration while making laws. The government should consider when they make laws. The government should consider these things. That is, it is not compulsory, or it is not a compulsion on the government to take this and make this law. No, what it is? It is only an advice. It is only some guidelines. These principles contain lofty ideas, deep human thought, belief, knowledge. These principles are not found in any other constitution of the world except those of India and Ireland. Where we can see this directive principles? Only in two constitutions in the world. One is of India's constitution and another one is of Ireland's constitution. Once again, here, what are the directive principles? You should know the meaning. Okay, you should know the meaning of the directive principle. These are guidelines to govern a country. Guidelines the government to govern. And this week, which part of the constitution deals with this? Part 4 of the constitution, articles 36 to 51. What are these? These are just guidelines. These are just guidelines. These are not laws. These are not laws. These are not guidelines. Okay. Only some the right way how to move. That is. Then which countries follow this? Two countries, one is India and another one is Ireland. So important thing is, what is it? Is welfare state. Okay, second point is important from this chapter is second one, the welfare state. What is a welfare state? A good country, a developed country, a country which takes care of the welfare of the people, that is called as a welfare state. Okay, a welfare state is a state which seeks to ensure the maximum happiness of maximum number of people living in its country. A country mainly concentrating on the happiness and welfare of its people is known as a welfare state or a welfare country. The Constitution of India seeks to establish India as a welfare state. Why do we have a constitution? To make India a welfare state. Okay. For the welfare of the people, we have what? We have the constitution. Although the word welfare state are not specifically mentioned in the constitution, so the welfare state as an aim, it is not mentioned. But for what purpose the constitution is made? The constitution is made for making India a good country, a welfare country, a developed country. Okay. The aims of the objectives of welfare are not clearly pointed out in the directive principles of state policy. These directives emphasize that the goal of Indian polity is a welfare state. So all the things that comes under the Indian Constitution and Directive Principles. What is the aim? To make India a welfare state, a good country. Good country, mainly what is the aim of a good country? The welfare of its people. The development of people. So this is what do you know, what you need to know about the welfare state. Okay, and just you keep it in mind, there are number of policies the government implement for the welfare. We can say, and for example, what Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. Okay, then what are other things? Pradhan Mantri Samman Nidhi Yojana. Then what is Pradhan Mantri Grameen Awas? We already said Pradhan Mantri Ujjwal Yojana. So gas, they give gas to the poor people. So Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. So there are a number of policies a government implement for the welfare of the people. Okay, so these are some examples. So keep it in mind. So this is what a welfare state means. Okay, the constitution. What is the main aim of the constitution? Welfare of the welfare of the nation. So this is what comes under the syllabus of third chapter. So please keep it in mind. There is, you need to learn only this.